Hi, this is Kurt at Travers Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about a few things regarding how to mill aluminum. Today we're going to talk just about some of the basics with milling aluminum so that you're more likely to hit the ground running and maybe take some of those jobs that you'd like to quote on. Aluminum in general is one of the most machinable types of material, and that's probably why it's the most common in most any machine shop. Aluminum is available in different grades. By far, the most common grade is 6061. All of them are very machinable, but they just have different characteristics. Check out our chart and you can see what those are. A big challenge with machining aluminum is preventing it from getting too hot, because when it does heat up, the aluminum tends to stick to the end mill, and sometimes it'll even break the end mill or chip it. If you're really looking to get the best tool for milling aluminum, here's a few tips on what to look for. Since aluminum is so different than steel or other materials, you want to stay away from the general purpose end mills and really go with something in solid carbide that's specifically for aluminum. First, let's talk about solid carbide end mills. I know they're a little bit more expensive, but it's going to be a better value if you get into high volume machining, because they last so much longer than any other kind of material. Another advantage of using carbide is you can run it at a much faster feed and speed. There's less tool deflection, which means you're gonna get a better finish, and it's gonna be a more accurate workpiece. And it's very dense material. It's a lot heavier even than high-speed steel or cobalt. And the advantage of that is that it takes a lot to heat it up. And as we said already, heat is an enemy to milling aluminum. Flutes are another real important part about selecting the right tool for cutting aluminum. The best choices are either 2 or 3 flute. So let's talk about each one of those. A 3 flute end mill is the best choice most of the time. It's an ideal balance between chip clearance and strength. However, a 2-flute end mill can be better for ramping and plunging. The reason for that is because both cutting edges go all the way to the center of the end mill, where on most 3-flute end mills, only one cutting edge goes to the center. Now let's talk about the helix angle, which is simply the angle that the cutting edge comes up off the axis of the tool. If you want an end mill for both roughing and finishing, somewhere around a 40 degree helix angle will be a good compromise. You can go less than 40 degrees if you want to do just roughing. It's not going to give you as good of a surface finish, but we're roughing, so who cares about the surface finish anyway? And then if you do want a good surface finish and you want a finishing end mill, go a little bit higher than that 40 degrees. And another advantage of a higher helix angle is that it gives you better accuracy. Another thing that people ask about is the coatings on end mills. For machining aluminum, you really don't need a coating, and some do more harm than good. Examples of a coating to stay away from is anything with AL in it. The AL stands for aluminum, and it doesn't work well for cutting aluminum. If you want coating on your tool, ZRN, which means zirconia nitride, is an excellent coating for machining aluminum. With all that being said, the next thing to talk about is cutting fluid. Just about anything will work. Never cut aluminum dry, but the best thing to use is something that's specifically for machining aluminum. Here's my personal order of priorities. Number one thing is cutting parameters. So in other words, how much am I moving the end mill over per pass or down into the workpiece material? Feed and speed is another cutting parameter. Number two would be cutter geometry. So I'd look for an end mill that's specifically made for aluminum. We're talking about helix angle here, number of flutes on it, things like that that are about the end mill. The third one would be about the coatings. Remember, we talked about what to stay away from. If I'm going to get a coating, it's probably going to be ZRN. And my last priority would be the cutting oil. I would definitely use it, but don't be too concerned about what type it is. To excel at machining aluminum, you're really going to need to do a little bit of experimenting. If you run into any issues, give our tech support a call and we can help.